photographs have so much detail in them that it's not really possible for anyone to look at a photo and know what is really important in that photo. An expert will come along and start pointing out all sorts of little things in the picture that make it significant. And then there's also the idea of art, the art of photography, and people will read a lot into that. And personally, I don't know if every photograph is art, but photography is so much more interesting than art to me that you have to respect it. We take glass negatives from the 19th century. We take all sorts of film negatives, including nitrate and diacetate. We take safety film. We take color slides and motion picture film. But the steps are, first of all, to house them in clean, acid-free enclosures, and then to identify them, see who the photographer was. It's sort of like having a lot of children and which one's your favorite. I just love them all. And the incredible breadth of variety of different subject matter here. I stumbled into newspaper microfilms as a source of information. And I noticed that there were so many mentions of both the photographers I was looking for, as well as other ones. That's what set me out to read all of the Oregon newspapers cover to cover from their first issue to 1900 in order to extract all the information about all of the photographers, which I published as my first book, 750-page reference book with information on 4,000 photographers. But that's a good example of how a challenge can inspire you. All these old photos, they don't do any good at all unless the public can access them. So there's a responsibility to identify them and catalog them and put them where people can find them on the internet if they're looking for them. And that is the prime source of what pays for everything around here.
Anybody else sees Miss Fanny Brown? Well, has anybody else sees Miss Fanny Brown? She ain't so good looking, but she lays that loving down.
We get a lot of orders for one of this and one of that.
She ain't young no more. She's 40 years old, she ain't young no more. But the way she loves you will make you come back for more. She left this morning, caught that morning train. She left this morning, caught that morning train. Well, I wonder if I'll ever see Fanny Brown again.
The internet is the greatest thing. It's so good to be alive when it was invented. It's like being alive when Gutenberg invented the press. It transformed the world, certainly as much as that event did. The internet has enabled anybody to get their work to an international audience immediately. And thus, it's never been easier. to make a living. The internet has made jobs obsolete. Anything that you can imagine and can create, you can market immediately. I think it's an amazing experience to be alive at a point where film becomes obsolete, because that puts a cap on film photography, and it will be up to another generation to try and figure out how to save digital images. But now we can say that it's finished, that chemical photography, which has been used for 150 years, that chapter is closed. And now we can collect it and make sense of it.